Welcome. In today's video, we want to look at how to install Sage Pastel Payroll on your laptop. Right, we are doing these video tutorials as a community service to the accountants profession in Zimbabwe. We are doing it to support professional accountants and students. Right, we also ask for your help to spread our reach by subscribing to our YouTube channel, sharing these videos with colleagues who can find them helpful, and also liking our videos. Right, if you want the installation files I'm going to be using here, you can WhatsApp your email address to 07881043333. That's a Zimbabwean number, 07881043333. We'll send you the installation files, then you can use the tutorial that we're going to show you here to install it on your laptop and practice. Right, without taking much of your time, let's get started. Now, the first step that you have to do in installing Sage Pastel Payroll is to install the pervasive database. Right, this is the engine on which the payroll system runs on. And for you to do that, you have to come here. So these are the installation files. I have the pervasive and the Pastel Payroll. This is the latest version, the 2023 version. So we're going to start with installation of the pervasive database engine. And for you to do that, you have to double click this folder. Right, when you double click this folder, it will open and it contains the installation files that we're going to be using. Right, and for us to install the pervasive engine, we have to come to this installation file and double click on it. Right, when we double click on it, it will start to run. We can close this window so that we have got a clear view of the installation process. So when it runs, we just have to wait. It will bring up this window, the welcome window to the installation wizard of pervasive PSQL version 10. So for us to continue, we have to click on next. Right, when you click on next, it will bring the license agreement. If you have got time, you can read through, but there may not be need. What you have to do is I accept the terms in the license agreement. That's where you have to click, then you click on next to continue. But when you click on next to continue, you are now taken to this window whereby you are supposed to select how you want to install the software. Do you want it to run as an application or do you want to run it as a service? It is recommended that you install it to run as a service. So for you to continue, you just have to come here and click on next. Right, then it will give you on the setup type, it will give you two options: complete, whereby you are installing all program features, right, or custom, which means you are going to select certain features that you want to install and leave out others. We recommend that you use complete, then click on next to continue. Yeah, then now taken to this window, the system is ready to install our program. Then click on install. So when you click on install, the installation will begin. You'll see progress in the status bar here. Shortly it will begin to run. Right, if your computer is a fast machine, this won't take time. If it is slow, it will take a bit of time, but no, not many minutes, just a few minutes or a few seconds to complete. So we just have to wait for it to begin the installation file, the installation process. So as you can see, it has begun. You can see activity in the status bar. So we just have to wait for it to complete. This is an automated process. So you just have to wait and allow it to complete so that it takes you to the next step. Wait for it to finish. It's almost there. So this is the initial step that you have to do before we install the Pastel, Sage Pastel Payroll. This is a pervasive database. All right, it may bring up this. It may bring up this. The upgrade page cannot be installed by Windows installer service because the program debugger may be missing, or the upgrade page may be may update a different version on the program. So what you just basically have to do with this message is to click on OK. Right. When you click on OK, the installation wizard will complete, and you just have to click on Finish. Right. Then you'd find it will probably bring up this. You just have to close. Just have to close this and also close this. Now, for you to be sure that your installation is completed, it will give you this message. PSQL activation return 7112 license is already installed. Then click on OK. Right. What does that mean? That means your pervasive, the database on which Pastel Payroll runs on, has been installed. Now you have to proceed and start installing your Pastel Payroll. And for you to do that, you just have to come to this installation file, right click on it, then run as administrator. Right. So when you click on it, it will begin to run shortly. You just have to wait for it to begin the installation process. So it will begin extracting that. You just have to wait while this is extracting so that it takes you to the next step. Right. So it's now preparing to do the installation. Okay, so now it's computing space, right? So after that, it will take you to this window, right, which is a welcome window. Welcome to the installation assistance for Pastel Payroll 2023 update 2. Right, as I said, this installation is for year 2023. You could actually use it to practice on how to do the Zimbabwean payroll using the current tax rules on pay as you earn, on NASA and another payroll item, because this is the current version. Now for you to continue, you click on next. Right, when you click on next, you are taken to the license agreement window. You can read through this license agreement if you've got time, but basically you just have to click on I accept the terms in the license agreement, then you click next to continue. Right, then when you click next to continue, you are taken to the custom setup. That Pastel Payroll is used in a number of countries here in Zimbabwe. As you can see, this not in Zimbabwe, in Africa. As you can see this list, they have for South Africa, Angola. So it's used in all these countries: Botswana, Ghana, Kenya, Lesotho, Malawi, Malta, Mauritius, Mozambique. So if you were to continue downwards, you could actually see Namibia, Nigeria government, Rwanda, Sierra Leone, Swaziland, Tanzania, United Emirates, Uganda, Zambia. Then Zimbabwe is down here. So by default, it activates South Africa. That's why you find there is no X against South Africa, but on these other countries, there are X's. So if you were to continue, it means you'll be installing the payroll for the South African market. In other words, the tax rules which will be in the payroll will be for South Africa. And as I said, we're doing it for the Zimbabwean market. So what do we have to do? We have to click on South Africa, right? I've clicked there. It will bring this feature will be installed. That is, if I wanted to have it installed, this feature and also folders will be stored on the local drive. But I'm clicking on South Africa so that I deactivate. This feature will not be available. So that's where I'm supposed to click. When I click there, you'll find there will be an X. Then I have to scroll down using this. Then I come to Zimbabwe. And now I have to remove the X on Zimbabwe. And how do I do that? I click on Zimbabwe. It will bring these three options which we saw on South Africa. This feature will be installed. This is what we want. So I'm going to click there. Right. When I click there, you'd find the X is removed. Right. Then it's going to install a demo company. The pervasive is already installed, so there is no need for me to install it again. Then it's also going to install the business intelligence community for Microsoft Excel. So for me to continue, I have to click on next. Right, when you click on next, it will take us to the destination folder, whereby you can actually use this share the pastel folder. That is everybody has got full access. That is if you want, or you will just take off the tick and install the self-service database on this destination. So depending if you want to share it over network, you can just tick there and then you click on continue. Right, it will take you to the ready to install the program window. Everything else that is required is there. Then for you to continue, just have to click on install. It will begin the installation process. Right, as it will be installing, you'll find it will be bringing these various windows. You can read through while least you are waiting for the Sage Pastel Payroll to install. Right, so we just have to again give it a few minutes for it to run the installation. And remember, as I said, support us. We're doing this as a community service. We're bringing these videos free of charge, but you can help us spread our reach by subscribing to our YouTube channel, by liking our videos. You can even share with fellow colleagues, people you know can find these videos useful. That is if yourself find them useful. But I hope they are helping you. So let's just wait for the installation to complete. And again, as I said, if you want these installation files, you can WhatsApp your email address to 0788104333. That's a Zimbabwean number, 0788104333. Right, so let's wait for it to install. It'll finish just now. Let's just give it a bit of time. Right, so in this video we're simply showing you how to do the installation. Of course, there are other videos which show you how to now navigate the payroll system, how to run a payroll using Sage Pastel Payroll. So all those videos, we'll be bringing you those videos as well. Just subscribe and like our YouTube channel and share, then you have access to all those videos. So let's just wait. It's now writing system restoration values. So just have again to wait for it to do that. And as I said, if your machine is slow, it may take a bit of time. If your machine is fast, it won't take much time. Right. So let's just allow it to finish. Now it's updating component registration. This is automated. Your task basically is just to wait and allow it to do what it does. And once it's complete, you'll be able to run your system. Right. It's just writing the registration keys. Right. So you have to practice. Of course, we'll be bringing you other videos on how to practice, which is very important. You're acquiring, you're studying various professions. It could be ACA, it could be CIMA, it could be CIS. You could have done a degree at university. But now these videos are meant to bring you the practical skill which is required in industry. When you get to work, you're supposed to know how to run a payroll, and we're doing these videos to give you that skill. That skill. At times in colleges or at university, they don't provide these tutorials. And of course, there will be a gap now from the theoretical knowledge you would have gained and the practical that you are supposed to have and apply at work. So we are trying to bridge that gap. We're trying to bridge that gap and help as much as we can. So we just have to wait for it. It's writing registration keys. And once it does that, once it's complete, it will allow us to navigate our payroll system. We just have to give it time. We're taking you through these steps so that you can do it on your own. If you face a challenge, that is for those who are going to send their email addresses to receive the installation files. If you face a challenge while it's installing, you can still WhatsApp and share the challenge that you are facing so that we help you install it. Because they say practice makes it perfect. Using this software is not theoretical. In as much as we give you the theoretical background, you have to practice. These are practical subjects. Right. I think it's almost there. As you can see, it's now updating the icons at the back there. So we just have to wait. Right. Installation assistant complete, meaning to say our program has been installed. So we just have to click on finish. Right. So now we have Pastel Payroll, Sage Pastel Payroll installed. So it's Sage Pastel Payroll and HR 2023. This is the latest edition. And now for you to operate your payroll, we're not going to get into much detail. We're just going to show you how to open and navigate it. You have to just double click on it. Right. This is a Windows program, so it gives you a shortcut on the desktop. And when you double click on it, it will start to run. Right. It will start to run. So it's just checking for updates at 38% complete. You just have to wait for it to complete. Then it will open. Then it will take you through the next steps that you have to take to make the program ready. It may give you this message, Excel reporting. Do you know that as a Pastel Payroll user, you have access to a free 60-day trial period for our BI, this is Business Intelligence Payroll Excel reporting module, right? So you can read through. So basically, I've been told that you've got that grace period of 60 days to use business intelligence, which allows you to connect. We are connecting the Sage Pastel Payroll to Excel, and they can extract business intelligence reports. So basically, you're just being informed there. You just have to click on OK. Right. So when you click on OK, your Sage Pastel Payroll opens. Right. You are using it for the first time, so you have to register. That's why you're taken to the registration assistant for Pastel Payroll and HR. Of course, there is a welcome message there. You can read it through. Then for you to continue, you just have to click on next. Right. We are registering this as a local server registration. So here are registration types. Of course, you can read through this. There are three types. Probably let me explain. You've got local server registration, which we are going to use. If we're installing this as a workstation on a network, right? If it was a workstation, then we're going to click that. If it was a remote server registration, we're going to click that, right? But because we are installing it on your machine, on one machine, we are using local/ server registration, which is the default method. That is the three types. Then you just have to click next. Then when you come to this window, registration details, if you had bought a license for this payroll, you are going to register it as you're going to put the registration details in here. But now, because we are just giving you this for practice, we have to register it as a demonstration. Then you click next to continue. Right. When you click next to continue, it will take you to this summary window whereby it gives you the details, the registration details of your demo. In other words, it's just telling you that the number of users will be one, unlimited employees in terms of HR people billing, unlimited. Then it will run from today up to this period. Then it will expire. Then So basically, this is the summary that you're getting from that. Then these are the modules that you're going to have, the base, the reporting, cancels, and everything. For you to continue, you just have to click on next. Then completing registration. So the system is now completing the registration process. We just have to give it time for it to complete the registration process. Right, registration complete. Now, thank you for choosing Pastel Payroll. Your software has been registered successfully and will expire on that date. Now you just have to click on finish. Right. When you click on finish, it may bring up, it will bring up over this window. You can either read through. If you don't want this window to be showing time and again, you just come here, do not show this message again, then you click on close. Right, so you have successfully installed Sage Pastel Payroll on your laptop or on your computer. Right, thank you for watching. Remember to subscribe, remember to like our videos, remember to share. See you in the next videos, whereby we'll be showing you how to set the Kanban file for your Sage Pastel Payroll. Thank you.